Committee President, good evening. Ms. Swaminathan. Dr. Madhura Swaminathan. Dr. Ajay Farida. Dr. Bruce Alberts. Dr. Sunita Narayan. Dr. Haurat Bhavi. Dr. Rajiv Varshini. Dr. Narayan Hegde. Sri Gopal Krishna Gandhi Ji. Distinguished devotees, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen. I extend my heartiest greetings and best wishes to Professor M.S. Swaminathan on his 90th birthday. It's a pleasure to participate in his 90th birthday celebrations program organized by M.S. Swaminathan Research Foundation, inaugurated the International Conference on Science, Technology and Public Policy for Achieving the Zero Hunger Challenge. Release the publications, M.S. Swaminathan, Combating Hunger and Achieving Food Security, Annual Report of MSSRF, and address this distinguished gathering here today. Hunger elimination has been the major goal of independent India. In 1946, Gandhiji said at Naukali that the first and foremost duty of independent India should be the eradication of hunger, since to the hungry, God is bread. Transformation of our country from a sheep to mouth existence to one capable of conferring the right to food has probably few parallels in human history. Therefore, on this occasion, I salute our farm scientists and farm men and women and the entire farming community for bringing about a sustainable development in agriculture. Our farmers are going through many difficulties, largely arising due to the vagaries of monsoon and the volatility of the market. The gap between scientific know-how and field level do-how should be bridged. With the onset of the era of climate change, irrigation security is going to be vital for food security. I commend the initiatives taken by M.S. Swaminathan Research Foundation for choosing the technological empowerment of rural families, particularly women and youth. Information technology, biotechnology, ecotechnology, natural resources, management, and post-harvest value addition should be given priority. The fisher-friendly application of modern mobile telephony is an exemplary transformational role of information technology. Empowerment of women in agriculture is imperative. Farmer-to-farmer learning will accelerate progress in technology dissemination and adaptation. Science and technology are the prime movers of change. The Green Revolution was a technological transformation of our agriculture, involving the design by scientists of a new plant architecture which can make better use of sunlight, water, and nutrients. Modern information technology is transforming the lives of rural, tribal, and coastal families. Yet, we have a long way to go to improve our farming technology techniques on par with international standards. Dr. Swaminathan's contribution to agriculture research and development has made an indelible mark on the food production in India. His advocacy of sustainable agriculture and call for an evergreen revolution has been recognized globally. The nation feels proud of its world-renowned agricultural scientist, Dr. Swaminathan, the father of green revolution. His contribution to the agricultural growth and development is unparalleled. It has led to a consequential effect in alleviating the widespread hunger and poverty, not only in India, but also worldwide. Professor Swaminathan is a renowned plant breeder and scientist par excellence. One of our prime tasks should be to motivate, attract, and retain youth in farming. This requires technological empowerment of young people with new technologies like biotechnology, information and communication technology, eco-technology, and space technology. We have to produce more and more food and other agricultural commodities under conditions of diminishing per capita land and water resources. This will call for appropriate technologies. There is also a need for making rainwater harvesting mandatory to combat water problems. Nearly 97% of the world's water is seawater. In the context of the increasing water shortage, it is important that we learn to utilize the seawater in an effective manner, both for agriculture and fisheries. I compliment Professor Swaminathan for initiating biosaline agriculture and also for establishing a regenerative garden of halophytes. We should learn how to use our natural resources and natural ecosystems in an economically and ecologically meaningful and sustainable manner. I am also happy that you are trying to convert agro-biodiversity hotspots into happy spots where local communities can derive benefit from their bioresources in an economically sustainable and socially meaningful manner. FAO studies reveal that nearly 1.3 billion tons of food grains are lost globally every year, either during production stage or the post-harvest stage. It is high time we sensitize on the measures to be taken and formulate plans to prevent pilferage of food grains right from production stage to post-harvest stage.